Welcome to the Office 365 update for May of 2017. In the next 10 minutes, I'll be giving you a quick rundown of what's new with the goal of helping you get the most out of your Office 365 investment. First, thank you to everyone who takes the time to send me feedback, especially to those who let me know how this series is helping you. As an example, you may recall that I talked about why some users see new capabilities before others in last month's client update cadence segment. A viewer wrote in to say he solved the mystery of why he wasn't seeing the latest features in his Office 365 client. He worked with his admin to change a few settings that I covered in the April video, and lo and behold, the missing features magically appeared during the next client update. With that, keep sending your comments, ideas, and success stories to the email address listed on the screen, and I or someone from my team will do their best to get back to you. On April 19th, Microsoft announced a new intelligent task management app that makes it easy to plan and manage your day. To-Do, now in preview, delivers a smarter, more personal, and intuitive way to help you stay organized and get the most out of every day. In the past, managing your to-dos could sometimes take as much effort as actually completing them. Microsoft To-Do helps you focus and plan your day from the moment you open the app. The integration with Outlook makes it easy to stay on top of your Outlook tasks from anywhere. To-Do is built on Office 365, which in coming months will make To-Do even more helpful in more places. As the only task management app built in an enterprise cloud, To-Do offers the advanced security that our Office 365 customers have come to expect. To-Do data, available across all your devices, is encrypted in transit and at rest. For commercial users, IT professionals can now enable the To-Do preview through the Office 365 Admin Center. Check out the April 19th Office blog post, which has links to the Microsoft To-Do preview for iPhone, Android, Windows, and the web. On April 11th, the Office 365 team announced another round of enhancements for Sway, the intuitive, media-rich app that makes it easy to create and share interactive reports, personal stories, business presentations, and more. The first enhancement is the ability to add audio recordings to your Sways to make them even more engaging and interactive. You can add pre-recorded audio or music, and you can also record audio directly in Sway. Second, Sway now supports closed captions, making any audio recordings you add more accessible. Third, the Sway team added a new feature to make it easier to get around. Just click on the new navigation icon, and you can quickly access any section of your Sway. Finally, there's a new autoplay feature for unattended viewing and a view count to see how many people have checked out your content. If you haven't yet discovered the power of Sway, the transcript includes a link to a great article on the Office support site on how to get started. Power BI has transformed the way I communicate with leaders here at Microsoft. That's why I was thrilled to see the Office Store introducing new custom Power BI visuals created both by Microsoft and by members of the Power BI community. Examples include Word Cloud, a visual representation of word frequency and value, which gives you insight into the most important terms in your data. Sandance, which enables you to see all your data as grains of sand with animated transitions between views to help you explore, understand, and communicate insights. And Correlation Plot, an advanced analytics visual based on R script to highlight data relationships. You'll find these free visuals along with over 50 others in the Office Store. People using Outlook for Windows and Outlook on the web have been able to leverage the power of groups from within Outlook for a while. Groups in Outlook are a bit like distribution lists, but they provide a whole lot more. I'm pleased to report that Groups functionality is now rolling out to Outlook for Mac, iOS, and Android, enabling access to group conversations and content from within Outlook, no matter which platform you prefer. More features are being added all the time, and the April 18th Office blog post lists some of them. You'll also find some frequently asked questions towards the end of the post that you'll want to take a look at. One frequently asked question I get is, what's the difference between Office 365 groups and groups in Outlook? Well, Office 365 Groups is the foundation that enables teams to collaborate while using the app of their choice. It could be Outlook, SharePoint, Skype for Business, Yammer, or Microsoft Teams. For example, those with a more email-centric culture might decide to use Groups in Outlook, while work groups interested in a chat-based experience could select Microsoft Teams. The important point here is that the choice is yours. Office 365 Groups is always there, behind the scenes, structuring and storing information, making it available across all these applications, while the groups themselves remain secure and easily manageable. One key benefit of Office 365 Groups is that any user in the organization can create a group and start collaborating with others in seconds. While self-service creation is great for users, IT admins need to be able to easily manage groups and ensure the group's data adheres to the organization's compliance policies. On April 6th, the Office team announced new management enhancements, including first, deleted groups restore, so deleted groups are now retained by default for 30 days and can be restored. Second, data retention policies, allowing you to keep what you need and get rid of what isn't needed. And third, label management that allows IT admins to classify Office 365 Groups emails and documents across the organization for governance and enforce retention rules based on specific label classifications. These new features round out the broad set of group management tools already available to Office 365 customers. There's a complete list of group management tools and a sneak preview of upcoming admin features in the April 6th Office blog post. Frontline workers are the heartbeat of many of the world's largest industries, such as manufacturing, retail, healthcare, and hospitality. They're the people behind the counter, on the phone with customers, operating the production line, and running the day-to-day operations. They don't always need the full power of everything Office 365 offers, but can benefit if provided with a subset of Microsoft's modern productivity tools. That's why on April 3rd, Microsoft announced the expansion of the Office 365 Enterprise K1 plan to include the following enhancements: Microsoft Staff Hub for schedule management, 2 GB of cloud storage on OneDrive for Business, Skype for Business presence and instant messaging, Microsoft Teams, the new chat-based workspace in Office 365, Office 365 Video, a destination for discovering and accessing video content, Microsoft Power Apps for custom application access, and Microsoft Flow for workflow. These new capabilities will be added over time, so visit the Office 365 Enterprise K1 plan page to learn more and check out the Microsoft Mechanics video embedded in the April 3rd Office blog post. Back in September of 2016, I discussed a new service in preview at the time called SecureScore. It's a security analytics tool that applies a score to an Office 365 customer's current security configuration and provides suggestions on actions that can improve their security position. Last week, my colleague Brandon Kohler released a short video that gives a great overview on SecureScore. If you're an Office 365 admin and are new to SecureScore, I highly recommend you watch Brandon's video to learn what you can do to increase your organization's security position in Office 365. On March 31st, the Office team announced the public preview of the new Microsoft Graph reporting APIs, which enable customers to access the data available in the Office 365 admin usage reports. Why? Well, Microsoft realizes that many Office 365 customers already have existing reporting solutions in place, such as a company-built reporting application or a custom web portal. The new Microsoft Graph reporting APIs enable organizations and independent software vendors to incorporate the Office 365 activity data into their existing reporting solutions. Any Office 365 admin with global admin or product admin rights in the organization can retrieve data through these APIs. To get started, check out the March 31st Office blog post, which has links to the Microsoft Graph documentation. That's it for now. Remember to send your feedback or success stories to Office 365 Update Series at Microsoft.com. I'm Jim Naroski. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next month.